إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, أخرج البخاري ومسلم في صحيحيهما من حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم قال بني الإسلام على خمس شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج البيت لمن استطاع إلى ذلك سبيلا. الإمام البخاري المسلم رحمهما الله compiled a hadith that is narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu anhuma. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam قال, he said, Islam is made of those five things. Imagine Islam to be a building. There are five pillars that make that building. Without these pillars, your Islam is no good. Al-Shahad, Al-Salah, Al-Zakah, Al-Sawm, Wal-Hajj. The third pillar, brothers and sisters in Islam, of this religion, Islam, is called Az-Zakah. The overwhelming majority of Muslims do not know what is the technical definition of the word Zakah. And they mix between it and another term, which is Sadaqa. And linguistically, or literally speaking, the word sadaqa means zakah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoken about the fact that zakah is mandatory, He said this, subhanahu wa ta'ala, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَة. Take from their wealth, sadaqah. So the Quran used the word sadaqah for zakah. also when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to us where the money that we pay for the zakah should go to or must go to, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah at-Taubah, إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَاتُ لِلْفُقَرَاءِ وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْعَامِلِينَ عَلَيْهَا وَالْمُؤَلَّفَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَفِي الرِّقَابِ وَالْغَارِمِينَ وَفِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ فَرِيضَةً. That means it's mandatory. فَرِيضَةً مِنَ اللَّهِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word sadaqah, but we know the sadaqah that is mandatory is called zakah. So a lot of Muslims do not realize that there is a difference between the zakah, the pillar, and the sadaqah, the mandatory, the optional, the extra. Just try to apply this to the salah that we pray. Fajr is 4 rak'ah. Fajr is 2 rak'ah. Dhuhr is 4 rak'ah. Asr is 4 rak'ah. Maghrib is 3 rak'ah. Isha is 4 rak'ah. This is the mandatory. The optional, praying 2 rak'ah before Fajr. Praying 2 or 4 before Dhuhr. 2 after Dhuhr. 2 or 4, 2 and 2 before Asr. If you want 2 before Maghrib and 2 after. And 2 and 2 after and before Isha. The same exact thing. Zakah is the mandatory portion of your money that you must pay. You must pay. For example, if you have $1,000 and you owe 2.5% in those $1,000, you must give $25 to these sources. So actually what you own is not $1,000, is 9975. The 25 is not yours. Those $25 is not yours. It belongs to the poor, to the needy. What is the difference between the zakah and the sadaqah? Like I said, az-zakah is mandatory. The sadaqah is optional. Az-zakah, it is upon you, required of you, once you possess certain wealth or properties. Cash, the value of which you can buy 595 grams of silver or 85 grams of gold. You must pay zakah if you have cash. If you have a bank account, in this bank account there is money with which you can buy 595 grams of silver or 85 grams of gold, you must give 2.5% of this money. Zakah, mandatory, you must, you have no choice. It's like not praying. It's like not praying dhuhr. But sadaqah, the other things, the other wealth, before I move on, cash, bank accounts, stocks that you own, and the value of which you still can buy that quantity of silver and gold, which they call the nisab, you must give zakah on it. If you are trading, urud al-tijara, if you are trading, Let's say you're trading in clothes, selling and buying clothes. If you have in your store clothes, that if you calculate the value of which is more than that quantity, you have to pay zakah on this clothes. Provided that you own it for a year too. You must own it for a year. And we're talking about a lunar year. Lunar. Not January, February, March. La Ramadan, Ramadan, Shawwal, this year. Because there is a difference. 11 days every year, there is a difference. If you have livestock, cows, camels, goats and sheep. If you have vegetation, and if you have found a treasure, they call it a rikaz, you must pay zakah. But sadaqah, in anything, your knowledge, you can give it as a sadaqah by teaching people. Your manpower, you can give sadaqah on your manpower by volunteering in the masjid. Your smile in the face of your brother is a sadaqah. You enjoying good and forbid evil is a sadaqah. If you say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, sadaqah. Bab al-sadaqah maftuh, open, anything. The zakah, brothers and sisters in Islam, must be given to certain people. The eight that I just quoted. The poor. The miskeen. Someone who just joined Islam. And he, at the verge, give him zakah. Make him love the religion. Al-mu'allafa qulubuhu. Fi al-riqab, your Muslim brother is enslaved. Free him. Al-gharimeen, your Muslim brother is in debt. Help him pay his debts. Fi sabilillah, the consensus, the causes of jihad. The zakat. A lot of people say, give it to the school, give it to the give it to buy books, give it to the orphans. La, zakat does not go to that. Zakatul mal does not go to that. Sabilillah means the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Building masjids also, no. Wabnu sabil. A wayfarer, someone who is traveling to California, he stopped in Colorado, a Muslim. The zakah must be given to a Muslim. You cannot give the zakah to a kafir or a non-Muslim. Sadaqah you could, if you know this person is going to become, mashallah, like Islam and is going to maybe become a Muslim because of that sadaqah, give him sadaqah. But zakah, la. You are punished if you do not pay your zakah. Sadaqah not, you're not. You are rewarded, but you are not sinful. The zakah must be given to the people locally. The evidence, hadith Ibn Abbas, wal hadith al Bukhari wa Muslim. Lamma ba'atha an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Mu'ad ibn Jabal ila al-Yaman. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent Mu'ad to Yemen, qala lahu ya Mu'ad innaka ta'ti qawman al-hadith. And then tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala iftarada صدقة تؤخذ من أغنيائهم وترد على فقرائهم. Allah has prescribed upon them a certain amount of wealth that is to be taken from their wealthy to be taken to their poor, their أغنيائهم, their to their. ويجوز نقل زكاة المال إذا كانت هناك ضرورة. But الأصل locally, it is permissible if there is a desperate need to transfer zakatul mal from a local place to another place, if there is a need. But by default, here. As-Sadaqa, sin, worldwide. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed the zakah, and again I'm talking about the zakah, the mandatory, that you have no option but to pay it if you are a Muslim. Free. And you possess the nisab. You have cash, bank accounts, stocks, merchandise, livestock, vegetation, fruits, no zakah on fruits. Vegetation, the value of which you can buy 5, 9, 5 grams of silver or 85 grams of gold, provided that you owned it for a year, then you must pay zakat. By the way, even if you are under the age of puberty, you open a bank account for your child who's 10 years old and he has that value in his bank account, he must pay zakat. Even so, he's not mukallaf. لسه صغير under the stimulus, لأن الزكاة على العين على المال. حتى المجنون the insane يدفع الزكاة, وليه يدفع الزكاة. حتى اليتيم, if you are put in charge of an orphan or orphan's wealth, you are to pay the زكاة on an orphan. Don't say he's an orphan and ما فيش زكاة على المليت. لا, لازم يدفع الزكاة في ميت النصاب. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters in Islam, prescribed the zakah for us, for this ummah, is for a wisdom. You know, the first person who benefits from paying zakah is the one who pays it. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خذ من أموالهم صدقة. Take from their wealth, O Muhammad, a sadaqah, which is the zakah again. Sadaqah here means the zakah, the mandatory zakah. Look, تطهرهم. It will purify them. It will purify you as a person and it will purify your money. What do you mean? The nafs that you have likes to keep possession. This is mine, mine, mine. And by the way, by default, we're all like that. Don't feel ashamed, we're all like that. We're all like that. But the believers, those who believe, who takes it out and give. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا. By default, the nafs of the human being is anxious, panicking. What am I going to do? I have this and I have that. What? إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا. When bad thing happens to him, oh, what am I going to do? On the other hand, وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ مَنُوعًا. And when Allah would give him some khayr, some goodness,
This is mine. قُلْ لَوْ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي.
شوف. If you possess the treasures of Allah, and you can imagine how much are in the treasures of Allah.
قُلْ لَوْ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي إِذًا لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ.
You will withhold.
وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ قَتُورًا.
And mankind by default is stingy. So when you give, you overcome your stingy nafs. You win. You see, you're in a fight with your nafs. Your nafs is telling you, mine, mine, mine. And you're telling your nafs, no, Allah is, Allah is, Allah is. You win that battle. That's what, تطهرهم.
قال الله تعالى ومن يوق شح نفسه فأولئك هم المفلحون.
إياكم والشح كما في صحيح البخاري أهلك من قبلكم الشح. Stinginess destroyed the people before you, the nations before you.
Zakat also purifies your wealth. Sometimes we earn money from a gray area.
You don't know what happened here with this deal.
Zakat purifies the money.
Zakat actually purifies the person who receives the zakat.
When a poor person in a community like this walking around and seeing the brothers rich, wealthy, and not sharing, what they're going to do? They're going to envy them. Man, he has a lot of money. Look at him driving this car. Oh, have you seen his house?
وَأَنَا مِشْ لَقَاكُلْ.
And I don't even have food to eat.
شوف. خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ.
Take from their wealth صَدَقَةً.
زكاة تطهرهم, to purify them.
وتزكيهم وصل عليهم.
When you give to the poor from your money, he makes dua for you.
صل عليهم means here make dua for them.
قل لك بارك الله لك في مالك.
Imagine a poor making dua for the rich.
ربنا يبارك لك يا شيخ, جزاك الله خير, ربنا يخلف عليك, ربنا يعوض عليك, وينبسط لك.
He becomes happy for you that you're rich.
Ya Rabbi, make him richer because he can give me.
Is zakah, brothers and sisters in Islam, helps remove the devastating consequences of poverty.
الفقر مشكلة على فكرة. Poverty is a problem.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم استعاذ منه.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم seeked refuge with Allah from poverty.
And you know when he did, he combined it with kufr.
اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الكفر والفقر.
Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from disbelief and poverty.
That means there is a relationship there. وفي الأمر تفصيل. يعني حديث الدمان هو wanted to give صدقة at night. والحديث في البخاري ومسلم, الحديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, a man from Bani Israel wanted to give صدقة at night in secret. He placed it in the hand of somebody in the morning. They said what? A prostitute, بغي, received a صدقة last night. The man became upset giving his zakah to a prostitute. He said, I will try again tonight. He placed it in the hand of a thief. A thief.
سارق. تصدق الليلة على سارق.
At the end of the hadith, he was told, يا هذا, oh so and so, Allah has accepted
your zakah, your sadaqah. This woman was doing this because she had no other option. And your zakah helped her stop. The thief, sharhu, the same thing. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to ask you this question. And honestly, be honest to Allah. Don't answer to me. Answer to Allah. When was the last time you got a piece of paper and a pen and you calculated what you owed and you found out if you pay zakah or net or not, and did you pay it or not? When the last time you did this? Don't answer me, akhi. أجب الله لأنك ستسأل. You will be asked. If not in the world, you will be asked in the day of resurrection. لا تزول قدم ابن آدم حتى يسأل عن خمس وفي رواية أربع ماله his wealth من أين اكتسبه. From where did he earn it? وَفِيمَا أَنْفَقَهُ. And how did he spend it? The most neglected pillar of Islam is the zakah. Hardly you find a Muslim يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ فِي هَذَا الرُّكْنِ. يَمْسِكْ كِذَا الْوَرَقَ وَالْقَلَمْ. A piece of paper and a pen, and he calculates. Hardly. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي. Rather, you will find some of the brothers going around, dollar here, dollar there, 10 there, 10 there, 10 here, 10 there, 20 here, 20 there. Did you pay your zakah this year? You know what? I give him this and this and that. We'll make this zakah. يلا. لا يصح. This is not zakah. This is called sadaqah. اسمع هذه. Listen to this. And place this in your ear and make it go into your heart. أجمع أهل العلم ولم يخرج عن هذا الإجماع إلا الإمام الأوزاعي رحمه الله. The vast majority of the jurists of this ummah, that niyyah must be there, intention must be there when you give the money, that this is for my zakah. You cannot, if you have paid $200,000 in sadaqah throughout the year and you owe $10 in zakah, you must pay the $10. Because the niyyah, the intention must be there before you do it. إنما الأعمال بالنيات. Like I said at first, a lot of the Muslims do not know the difference between sadaqah and zakah. And that is why they treat it in this way. A lot of the Muslims do not know that there are consequences for not paying your zakah. And I want to tell you something. In this dunya, before the hereafter, there are positive stuff, you know. I could share that with you. That Allah will bless your wealth. وَمَا آتَيْتُم مِّن زَكَاةٍ تُرِيدُونَ بِهَا وَجْهَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُضْعِفُونَ. الله will. وَمَا أَنفَقْتُم مِّن شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ. Whatever you spend, Allah will replace it for you. يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَاء وَيُرْبِي صَدَقَاتِ. Your money will increase. ثَلَاثٌ أُقْسِمُ عَلَيْهِنْ. Three things I'm willing to take an oath on. كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في سنن الترمذي من حديث أبي كبش الأنماري. One, ما نقص مال من صدقة. Your money will not decrease because of the صدقة. وهذا المعنى في كتاب الله وما أنفقتم من شيء فهو يخلفه. And whatever you spend, Allah will replace it for you. هذا جانب الترغيب. الترهيب. You don't want to hear about it, but you have to. You have to. One, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day addressed the Muhajirin. والحديث في سنن ابن ماجه وصححه أهل العلم حديث ثوبان عفوا حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص رضي الله عنهما قال يا معاشر المهاجرين يا معشر المهاجرين أو immigrants خصال خمس إذا ابتليتم بهن وأعوذ بالله أن تبتلوا بهن بهن. Five things, if you're afflicted with, and I seek refuge with Allah, that it does not happen at your lifetime. And he mentioned one of them, إِذَا مَنَعْتُمْ أَمْوَالَ الزَّكَاةِ. If you stop paying your zakah, مُنِعَ الْقَطْرِ, no more rain. ولولا البهائم ما مطرتم. And has it been for the livestock, الأنعام, the animals? Allah would not have sent any rain to you. فأبلاي this. If you withhold, Allah will destroy your money. ومن يبخل فإنما يبخل عن نفسه. If you're stingy, you're stingy on yourself. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, every single day, ملكان, اللهم أعطي كل منفق خلفا وأعطي كل ممسك تلفا. Two angels, every single morning. Oh Allah, replace, give the one who gives and destroy the wealth of the one who does not give. How many amongst us, between them and Allah, oh Allah, if you give me $100,000, I will do this and this and this with it. I will give sadaqa, I will give zakah. Allah giving him the 100,000. Insa. Forgot. Shuf. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهُ. وهذا في القرآن. وبعض الكتب بتاعت التفسير تنزل هذه الآية على صحابي جليل اسمه ثعلبة, وهذا الحديث لا يصح, هذا الحديث لا يصح. Some of them made a covenant with Allah, لئن آتانا من فضله, if he gives us of his bounty, لنصدقن ولنكونن من الصالحين. We'll give sadaqa and we'll be righteous and pious. فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. And when he gave him them, what did they do? بَخِلُوا بِهِ وَتَوَلَّوا وَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. They withhold and they turned away. Look at the punishment. Look at the punishment. A punishment that you don't want to hear about. فَأَعْقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will afflict those people with being hypocrites. نفاق في القلب. هذا الإنسان يتحول إلى منافق. ينافق. بِمَا أَخْلَفُ اللَّهَ مَا وَعَدُوهُ. Because they break their promises with Allah. وَبِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ. When a person is about to die, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, he would say, oh Allah, akhirni, fa'assaddaq, so I can give sadaqah. Fi dunya. Akhi, in the day of resurrection, which is 50,000 years long day, the person who owed zakah, the mandatory, I'm talking about the mandatory, I'm not talking about the sadaqah, I'm talking about the pillar, the 2.5%, and he did not pay it, will have a very interesting 50,000 years. Subhanallah, he lives here in this dunya. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, kama fi sunan al-Tirmidhi, min hadith Abi Huraira, a'amaru ummati bayna sittin wa sab'in. He lives only in this world 60 years or 70 years or more. Maybe 100. He keeps all the money and look what happens to him in the day of resurrection. In a day that is what? 50,000 years. Imagine. Number one, a snake.
والحديث في صحيح مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم
Anyone who owes zakat al-mal from the money إلا ومثل له شجاعا أقرع يوم القيامة له ذبيبتان
A snake that will chase him on the day of resurrection.
And he will say, come here, I'm your money. أنا كنزك, أنا مالك, come here. Come.
هذه واحدة. اقرأوا إن شئتم. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by the way, after he made that statement, he said, recite if you want.
ولا يحسبن الذين يبخلون بما آتاهم الله من فضله هو خيرا لهم بل هو شر لهم سيطوقون ما بخلوا به يوم القيامة.
That's the snake.
في القرآن قرأها النبي. You have gold and silver that reaches the 85 grams, as I said, and 595 grams, and you do not pay zakat on it.
والذين يكنزون الذهب والفضة ولا ينفقونها في سبيل الله فبشرهم بعذاب أليم.
And those who withhold the zakah.
If you want to keep a lot of silver and gold, هذا قول ابن عباس. يعني ابن عباس يقول,
if you pay your zakah on your silver and gold, even if you pile them up, no problem. Even if you have a room filled with gold and silver, but you pay the zakah on it, no problem. This verse does not apply to you. La, we're talking about those who have gold and silver and do not pay the zakah.
Look what happened to them in the day of resurrection.
إِلَّا وَصُفِّحَتْ صَفَائِحَ مِنْ نَارِ
It will turn into blades.
فَيُحْمَى بِهَا فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمِ
And it will be heated in the hellfire.
You know, the hellfire of Al-Akhirah is 69 times more our fire here. More than our fire here.
And then he will brand it, be branded.
نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يحفظنا.
فالأمر serious.
النبي حتى تكلم وصاحب الإبل وصاحب الغنم وصاحب البقر.
اتقوا الله. Fear Allah.
وَأَدُّوا زَكَاةَ أَمْوَالِكُمْ
And pay your zakah.
Make this Ramadan a new beginning
once it comes to your wealth.
And pay your zakah.
أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.